In the previous video, I outlined some of the benefits of South Wales Metro and how it promises to transform rail travel in the valleys. In this video, we'll be taking a look at the proposals to create what has been coined Cardiff Crossrail, and I'll explain why Transport for Wales has chosen to purchase Class 398 Citylink tram trains for its metro services. Cardiff Crossrail centres around the Bute Town branch line, otherwise known as the Cardiff Bay Line, with the ultimate aim of providing a tram-style system connecting Cardiff Central Station to the Cardiff Bay area. To enable this, we'll require building new platforms at Cardiff Central Station in the southern car park, and a link from the new platforms along Callaghan Square, joining the Cardiff Bay Line to the south of Herbert Street. The new line will provide the first on-street section of what is hoped will be a much wider tram network. This leads us on to why TFW has chosen to purchase tram trains, as the units will eventually run effectively on a tram network, as well as on heavy rail lines in the valleys into Cardiff. The units therefore have to meet the requirements for both light rail systems and heavy rail lines. So effectively they are trams, but must meet the requirements to operate on the conventional rail network. The units have a top speed of 62 miles per hour, which may sound slow, but the core valley routes on which they will operate have stations which are close together, so this top speed should be more than sufficient. The Class 398 will also be able to accelerate much more quickly than the outgoing Class 150 DMUs, which is one of the reasons why TFW will be able to increase the number of trains per hour operating on the network. The use of tram trains has not been without its critics, and the lack of onboard toilets has been raised as a concern. Although TFW sees the network as a metro, that doesn't negate the fact that the journey from Merthyr Tydfil to Cardiff Queen Street currently takes 59 minutes, which is a long time to wait if you're caught short. Despite the Class 398 being able to accelerate much more quickly, I don't believe the journey time will be reduced significantly, so the lack of toilets does have the potential to be an issue for some passengers. The Class 398 also have fewer seats than the outgoing Class 150s. However, this will be more than made up for with the doubling of the service frequency from 2 to 4 trains per hour in the week during the day. The 40-metre long 3-car units have 96 standard seats, plus 31 tip-up seats, and are designed to carry an additional 126 standing passengers. The units also have 2 spaces for wheelchairs and 6 for bikes, per 3-car set. Although the units can and will operate in multiple to form 80-metre long 6-car trains. Once the metro upgrade is complete, Cardiff Bay will be served by 6 trains per hour, with 2 trains from Treherbert, Aberdare and Merthyr Tydfil running to Cardiff Bay, calling at the new Bute Town station, which is nearing completion. The Cardiff City line will be served by 2 trains per hour, whilst the other diagrams will operate into Cardiff Central via Queen Street. Improvements are being made to the Cardiff Bay Line prior to the opening of Cardiff Crossrail, and a new station is currently under construction. Bute Town Station is located on Bute Street, adjacent to the junction with Maria Street and Letton Road. The station structure, which is quite modest, looked largely complete in August when I visited, and TFW are aiming to open the new station in early 2025. The upgrade of the line also includes the addition of a second platform at Cardiff Bay Railway Station, which also includes passive provision for the addition of a third platform and through running in future. Work on the second platform also looked to be largely complete when I visited, although I believe the new Bute Town Station and new platform at Cardiff Bay will open at the same time. Some CG renders of Cardiff Bay appear to show overhead line equipment, but this is for a conductor which will be used to charge the Class 398 in the station, and there are no plans to electrify the Bay Line as far as I know. The new tram trains may not prove popular with all passengers, but they are seen as a key component of Cardiff Crossrail. The consultation for the first phase is currently ongoing and closes at the end of this month. There are still a number of drop-in sessions planned before then if you live in the area and want to know more. I'll also leave a link to the consultation page in the description below. The budget for the first phase is expected to be £100 million, with £50 million coming from the UK Government's Levelling Up Fund and £50 million from the Welsh Government. This may seem like a staggering amount of money for a relatively modest extension, but it does include the complete remodelling of Callan Square and the addition of a third platform at Cardiff Bay Station. It is just an unfortunate fact that trying to remodel streets to add tram lines is very expensive, not least because it usually involves extensive utility diversions before construction can even begin. Once the consultation closes, the full business case will be submitted, and then after that, a Transport and Works Act order will have to be submitted, which will hopefully be signed off by 2026. If funding is agreed, then work will begin in 2026, which will hopefully be completed by 2028 or 2029. Cardiff Crossrail Phase 1 is in itself seen as a stepping stone to wider extensions in future, with plans to extend the Cardiff Bay Line further into the bay, with plans being developed for a new section of track and stop on Pierhead Street. The new platform at Cardiff Bay and new station at Pierhead Street are seen as key elements of the Atlantic Wharf development, which includes the construction of a new 15,000 capacity arena. The plans for the redevelopment appear to include a new footbridge over the Cardiff Link Road, which would improve access to the new station at Pierhead Street if constructed. The lack of toilets may be a big concern for passengers, but the ultimate aim of providing improved links from the valleys and across Cardiff do promise to further improve connectivity across South East Wales, and further add to the transformative benefits that South Wales Metro promises to provide.